Welcome once again. And we are still on Rolle's theorem. That's one of some of the differential theorems that we'll be looking at. And previously we looked at an example on the Rolle's theorem, but now we want to see another example. We are to determine whether this particular function satisfies the Rolle's theorem in this interval. So when the question comes to this, what is the first thing you need to remember? They are mentioning Rolle's theorem, so you need to recall what the theorem is all about. So if you have difficulties in recalling the theorem, then you don't have much problem, because there are videos on that theorem already. Just look for that video, watch it, and there are practical ways of showing the theorem, and you'll be fine. Okay, but for the purposes of this example, I need to remind you that the theorem says that and the given function should be continuous on the closed interval. Okay, then the first derivative of the function should exist in the open interval. So the open interval of this one becomes 1, 2. So the first derivative of the function should exist in the open interval. So we have two things there. First, it should be continuous on the closed interval. Second, it should be what? The first derivative should exist within the open interval. Then the function value at 1, that's the first listing. Looking at the interval, the first value within the interval should be the same as the function value for the second value within the interval. If that is the case, then we say that there exists a certain x naught such that the first derivative of the function at that x naught gives us 0. So let's get to business and see how we handle this and conclude whether or not this satisfies the theorem. So we start with, we want to find out whether the function is continuous. So we have f of x here and square plus 5x plus 3. And the interval we are looking at is a closed interval 1, 2. Now, this function is already continuous because why is a polynomial function, and unlike rational functions that we are always afraid of asymptotes and the rest, but this one is continuous. So we just say that f of x is continuous on the closed interval. If it is continuous in the closed interval, we want to see whether the derivative of this function, the first derivative, was also continuous on the interval. So we find the derivative. So f prime of x is equal to 2x plus 5. So that this one is continuous. So we say that f prime at s is continuous. So it's going to be continuous on the open interval 1, 2. It's continuous and you have that. But the next thing to check as far as the theorem is concerned is as to whether the function value at 1 is the same as the function value at 2. So we say that f at 1 means we substitute 1 for x. So this plus 3. And this is given as 6. We are getting something like 9. We have 9 here. F at 2 will give us 2 squared, then plus 5, 2 plus 3. We'll give this as 10, and this is 4, 7. I think we are getting 17. Oh, there is a problem. You realize that this is 17 and this is 9. The condition is that f at 1 should be equal to f at 2 for us to continue. Now you realize that f at 1 is not equal to f at 2. F at 1 is not equal to what? F at 2. But this one is one of the necessary conditions for us to conclude that the function satisfies the theorem. So at this point, we don't have to continue. See, we don't have any problem again. We just stop here and conclude that no, once this one is not equal to this, the function. This particular function doesn't satisfy the Euler's theorem in this particular interval. So we say that since f at 1 is not equal to f at 2, f of x equals x squared plus 5x plus 1 does not satisfy the Euler's theorem. It does not satisfy the Euler's theorem on 1, 2. Okay, so this is very instructive. So it does not satisfy the Euler's theorem on 1, 2. This is very instructive. And so you realize that since this is not equal to this, f of s equals, so realize that you have, okay, so there's a little error here. Okay. Now this one does not satisfy the Euler's theorem on the closed interval. Okay. So what this tells us is that anytime we are asked to show whether or not a function satisfies the theorem within the interval, then we just look at the characteristics and the features as far as the theorem is concerned. Once one of the features is not satisfied, you can conclude that the theorem has been satisfied. So that's why we are concluding that the function f of s doesn't satisfy the Euler's theorem in this particular interval. Right, thanks very much for watching this particular video. Introductory analysis is concerned. I would like you to join me in the next video where I talk about other differential theorems like the mean value theorem, the Cauchy mean value theorem, the indeterminate forms, and the rest of the differential theorems, which are very much necessary as far as your course is concerned. Thanks very much. Catch you next time. Bye.